What is up, everybody? My name is Beau Tyler. I make music. This is my studio, and it's another episode, episode number 2 to be precise, of Beats with Friends. This was originally just another stream video that we turned into a proper video by editing it down. But when I was scrubbing through, since I edited this one myself, I noticed that I kind of covered pretty much every step of the process. I don't know if this will be the perfect video for an absolute beginner, but if you're someone who's already at least somewhat familiar with your machine, I think this video could be a pretty comprehensive guide on not just sampling, but resampling. But the real thing I was doing in this video was checking out Arcade's new note feature. And I'm not sponsored by them. I have no affiliate links. I just love Output. I love their plugins. But Arcade has seemed to do a bit too much of the work for me, and I'm a big believer that the more time you sit with your samples during the recording process, the more ideas you get, because you're focused on other things, you're not putting pressure on yourself, and then all of a sudden, ideas just start coming to you. I'm a big believer in that. I kind of love the meditative process that is discovery. I like sampling, is what I'm trying to say. Anyway, so in this video, we check out Arcade's new note feature, because now with Arcade, with their Arcade 2.0, I think they're calling it, maybe it's like 7.0, I don't know, it's a new version. You can now not only download samples and loops, but individual notes so that you can play them on your piano. Now, my complete control needs a new sustain pedal, because I've put so many miles on it. So I did it all from my machine today, but whatever DAW you're using, whatever your groove box, as long as you can download Output, all these principles will apply. No more talking, let's get into it. Hope you dig it. Peace.
Note kits can be accessed in the browser in a few different places. When you are in the Lines page, a keyboard icon with a number to the right will indicate how many note kits are found within that line. Clicking here on the artwork will take you inside the line. Click inside the tab to preview, download, and favorite note kits. When you hover over a kit that has been downloaded, you can click the center of it to access the play page, which displays the currently loaded kit and its controls. The keys are mapped chromatically like a piano, which makes note kits more suitable for writing your own melodies and progressions.
Arcade, you know, the way it used to work, you know, it used to be where on the white keys, there were samples, and it's just, what they did is, you know, they're making sample packs, essentially, but they're also building a software designed to use those samples in a certain way to chop and scrum. So it's really handy for the producer. Like I said, I don't use Arcade a lot. I use Arcade and I'll empty out the sound and throw my own sounds on them to use their tech, just because I prefer to chop my own stuff. I just think it's a lot of fun, and the process of chopping things gives you time with the sound, and you kind of turn your brain off because you just go into functional step-by-step mode. And for me, when I empty my mind that way, ideas always just start coming out. Melody, things to sing over it, guitar riffs, beats, stuff like that. So I find the time of exploring a sound or a chop very important. I love jumping on programs, you know, on an iPad that can make a beat really, really quickly, but I don't feel proud of it at the end, you know what I mean? No matter how good it sounds, because I wasn't inside of it, you know what I mean? I didn't get all up in there, so to speak. But this could be a game changer, because in the 5 minutes I spent with Arcade, I was like, oh my God, this is so awesome. Let me show it to you before we jump into it so you can see what I'm talking about. I want to check out note kits, because this is the new feature. And you know what? Let's just go through some previews. If we find a sound we like, we'll throw it in the machine on one of the groups. But my sustain pedal is broken. Otherwise, I'd be using my keyboard right now. So we're going to play on here tonight. I duplicated that over to group C. Let's open Arcade back up. We got some drums, we got some bass. Let's find these chords. That's it, that's the one I want. It's not what I was using earlier. I think this was, actually. Let's grab both of those. Just to kind of have a vibe, let's play through these and see what we can do with these. So it's a filter, a little reverb over here, spreader for the stereo. Let's go over to this other one real quick. I'm just going to grab these same chords. Let's hear those together, yeah? And let's just put it over here on sound two. Delete that group. Should all be playing together now. One thing I wish is that we could actually put MIDI on the group level so that any sounds we had in here, it was triggering all of them. You can do that through links and routing, but like Logic allows you to do that if you have a bunch of tracks and you put them in a summing folder. You can then put effects or things on that master level and have it go through, or you can put MIDI and have it feed sounds in. I think that would be a really cool feature on the machine. That's cool, Blast. I had no idea. So you could do that in Serato. One of these days, I'll take a look at that. It's a little loud. Let's turn that down. I'm going to end up side chaining these together. So right now, there's a bit more attack than I'd like there to be. Here on sound two, we'll turn that down. It's nice. One of them's spread and one of them's right in the middle. There we go. And I'm just kind of full steaming ahead right now. We can talk about whatever you want in the chat while I make music. You want to talk about your memories of 1995, June 17th, superstar, future Hall of Famer, in a car chase in the back of a white Bronco? We can talk about that. It's whatever you want. I only remember that vividly because I celebrated my birthday that year. And all I wanted to do was open my presents. And all anyone else wanted to do was watch O.J. Simpson run from the police at 40 miles an hour. I get it. But O.J.? The guilt you should feel for that day. I mean, you spoiled my birthday. What could be worse, right? Some things could be worse. All right, let's keep going. Let's open up another case of arcade. We're just going to keep stacking these up. Yeah, let's open it back up and let's find there are some cool voices in here. Download that. All right. And then what key are we in? What key was I just playing? I think I was playing in C minor. You know what? I want to put on here, actually, just right off the bat, just to get weird. Let's open up another output plugin that I love called Portal. Instantly something dope. Oh my god. So one thing I want to do real quick is I don't like the way it's cutting off so much. I like the glitch, but it's too much. So let me put on some reverb here so I can give everything a little bit of a tail. Let's roll back on Portal a little bit. Filter on here. It's not supposed to sound that good just from turning it on, right? actually really like the second half of what I did on the hats a lot better than the first half when I wasn't playing eighth notes. I was just playing quarter notes. Just to clean up this automation, jump down here and I'll just grab like the lowest half. This is the same thing if you've ever needed a visualization of what a compressor does. Compressor takes those lowest notes and it brings them up. And it would take these highest notes and bring them down. Yeah, you know what? Let's work like a compressor. Just bring it all down and squash it just a little bit. Just to satisfy a curiosity that I have, I want to come in here and look at the sampler on these hi-hats. Someone said reverse echo in the chat, and I would just happen to be thinking about the hi-hat when that happened. So, and actually, this might be a really cool time to try out the ice reverb. This could be a total waste of time. Could be amazing. I hate that. Let's just use a normal reverb. See, I broke my own rule there. Like, if something works, stop thinking about it and move forward. I was like, no, sounds perfect. Let's find something better. Don't we all do that, right? All right, we'll need to turn it down in the mix just a little bit. That could be distracting to some people, but I don't care. I make music that I like. Good thing we had that bass earlier. Now, what chords were we using over here? Okay, so C, D, A flat, B flat. And actually, I don't know if we can, because it's an arcade. I don't know if I can make that legato. Just looking for glide or polyphony. Here we go. We want legato mode. That's something. We're getting somewhere. Let's create a pocket. I mean, you can do this on any DAW. It doesn't matter what you're on. As long as you can sidechain a gate, you can do what you see me do annoyingly all the time, I know. Let's go up to internal and let's grab a gate and load that in. And then here on the gate, let's go and change our input source to the kick. Make it a little longer with our hold feature. Cool, that's dope. Let's add some swing. We need to get some feel in this song. Start around 20%. Now's a good chance, by the way, so we can really start feeling something here. On those chords on group C, let's go to the group. Now we will add a compressor. And to the input, let's make it the kick drum. Let's add a gate to this as well. Let's sidechain it just like the other one. Swing, and I'm probably going to turn the tempo down just a little bit. So the swing, let's get up to triplet territory. Let's go up to 33. Now this is going to start affecting like the timing of that reverse. When you're affecting swing, you're affecting a part of the tempo, and then the other part has to compensate for what's been sped up or slowed down to keep the same tempo. And when we're dealing with samples that we've timed up, they might start sounding broken, so we may have to work on them or choose to lay back on the swing. Let's do some work on that vocal. Let's turn our perform effects on and let's go to stutter. find something we like and we'll automate it in. I definitely want to bounce this. So in that case, we'll open up group E, we'll open up the sampler and we'll go to internal and we're going to sample group D for 4 bars. So now that we've got that, we should have this. And then I also want to grab the chords. I want to do the same thing. So let's open this up and we'll open up the sampler. Let's go over to internal and we're going to sample group C, but I'll do it without that gate on. I want the whole thing. You know, I'll do one without. I'll have both. That'll be a cool option. Let's get rid of it. We'll commit. I'm going to do the same thing for bass, one with, without, and watch the way I use these when I put them in audio mode. Ooh, I got something to show you. So here on group E on the sampler, let's grab group B, right? So internal, B, 4 bars, start, let's go. Crack that whip. All right, that's good. Now let's go back over here and yeah, let's do one without the gate. Let's go to all of these and on the plugin level, on the sound level, let's switch from sampler to audio on both of them. Would sound something like this, going back and forth like. So there's a lot of ways we can get clever with that. We can honestly create something new, resample that, chop that. Sometimes an entire session for me is like just going back and forth between like sampling something, doing cool stuff to it. And then rather than being done, I'm like, cool, now let's resample that and do something else to it. Especially if I'm using a loop or a sample that I know other people are going to be using. And I want to get as far away from any content ID problems or stuff like that. With the original sample, I'll just keep going. Dude, you can make a day of it. It's crazy. And where you end up 3 hours later is nuts. Here on group C, let's do the same things. Cool. So let's change that to audio. And let's change that to audio. There we go. And over here on group D, let's change this to audio as well. Everything's audio now. Put that on gate mode, and I like pretty much everything on gate mode. I want to control when it's cutting through, you know? Let's look over here on the chords. Fix a few of these real quick.
Alright, before we get into this final jam, I just wanted to tell you all thank you so much for watching. If you dug this content, be sure to hit that like button. And if you haven't before, why not go ahead and subscribe? Maybe even hit the notification bell. You can always unfollow me later if I let you down as a content creator and you decide, I hate this guy. But I'll try not to let that happen. And if I do, easy fix. Either way, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you dug all these tips, these tricks. I hope you dug Arcade just as much as I did because I think it's a much more musical instrument, much more conducive to really being creative. Just another win for output. I think this hurts some other companies and competitors out there that have tried to beat them to the punch on this because they're output and they're probably gonna win that war. Anyway, I hope you all dug it. Until next time, I'm Beau Tyler. I made music. Peace.
never grooved up.